Today, everybody, we are going to learn a couple of phrasal verbs about traveling. So if you like to travel, if you want to be able to communicate better in your trips, then keep watching this video until the end and you are going to learn a lot more. Stick around and let's go in just 3, 2, 1. Let's begin, guys. And the phrasal verb to begin with is going to be to see somebody off. So to see someone off means to go to the train station, airport or a bus station, doesn't matter, to say goodbye, to say farewell to somebody who is leaving. Yes? For example, my friend is going to travel for a couple of months tomorrow. So I'm going to go to an airport with him to see him off. To say goodbye and to say farewell to him whatsoever, yeah? So, remember, to see someone off is to go with them to the train station, airport, whatsoever, and say goodbye to them. Getting down to number two, guys, and this one is to set off. So, to set off is easy, is to start your journey, to start your trip. So, I'm going to set off tomorrow. It means I'm leaving tomorrow. I have my airplane tickets, I have my hotel reservation, whatever I need. So, I'm setting off tomorrow. I'm leaving my home and going to start traveling tomorrow. Moving on, everybody. And this next phrasal verb is to hold up. And you can use it differently. For example, like wait a second. So, hey, hold up for a sec. I just want to go have lunch with you together. Is that okay? No, are you kidding me? We're enemies. I hate you. Why would I ever have lunch with you? Just leave me alone, okay? So unlike this unlucky situation for me, usually people will stop and listen to what you want to tell them. Then another meaning of to hold up means to be delayed by something. Yes, so yesterday my flight was delayed for a couple of hours, so it held me up, and today I'm late for work, or I'm late for my trip, or I'm late for anything. Yes, so if something holds you up, it means it makes you wait. It makes you being late for something else. So it's not good when something holds you up. It's bad. All right, moving on, everybody. The next phrasal verb is to take off. It is very, very simple. It is the action when an airplane takes enough speed to leave the ground. All right, so taking off is like the process when airplane stops touching the ground and goes into the sky. So the next phrasal verb, guys, is to check in. And you can either check in to the airplane or to the hotel. So if we are talking about planes, you go to the airport with your passport and you just give it to the people on the counter. Yeah, so they just register you for a flight and give you the boarding pass. Of course, if you bought a ticket before, if you do not have any tickets, they cannot register you in and they cannot check you in whatsoever. So buy your tickets first and then go for a check-in. Then for the hotel, it's the same. You book your hotel forward, yes, like a day before, a week before, whatever, yes? Then you come to that hotel, you give them your passport and money if you need, and if you have, of course, they check you in and you can take the key and go to your room. That's what it means to check in. To get off. It is very simple, guys. It means to leave your mode of transportation. If you're on an airplane, it means to leave, to get out of your airplane. If you're on the train, it means to leave your train. Bus, leave your bus, whatever. So to get off means to get out. It means to leave your mode of transportation and just proceed, go wherever you're going. Moving down to the next phrasal verbs, everybody, and this one is to check out. Remember we had to check in to the airplane or to the hotel? Well, here, check out, you can only check out from the hotel. You do not need to check out from an airplane. So to check out from the hotel means to go to the reception desk, give them your keys for your room, of course, not for your house, and, well, pay. Maybe you need to pay right now when you're checking out, or maybe you paid before, it doesn't matter. So when they say, it's okay, sir, you can leave now, thank you for visiting, it's when you have checked out. So to check out is to give them your keys and leave the hotel room. Get away. So to get away, guys, is to have a vacation. It means like to get away from everything, from your life, from your work, from any routine that you don't like. So that is to get away, to have some vacation. Like, today I'm working, tomorrow I'm working, but then I will finally get away for 2 weeks. I'm going to Japan. Yay, my favorite country. So, to get away, remember, guys, is to start your vacation. Yeah? When you're finally stopped working and you go somewhere you want to. Or It doesn't have to be travel. Well, you can go to a lake house or whatever. Well, it means to have a vacation. Stop working, stop your routine, and get away from everything that you don't like to have some rest. Moving on, guys, and the next phrasal verb is to get on. So to get on means to get on board of an airplane, bus, train, whatever, yeah? So I know a lot of people think that you're getting in an airplane, bus, or train. Like, of course, logically, you go inside, right? But in English, we don't say you go in an airplane, you go in a train, or whatever. No, you say on. I have to board on my train. I'm flying on a plane. Yeah? It's not like you're actually on top of the plane. No, you would not survive there. Hey, sir, what are you doing up there? Get down here. Get down here. Come on, quickly. But you told me to. I have my ticket, so you told me get on the train. And here I am. I'm on the train right now. Can we just leave now? Now, guys, let's talk about drop off. So to drop off has two meanings. First one is just to basically take some baggage and drop off somewhere. Like, not to throw it. No, it actually means to put it gently. But you can call it to drop off. Like, today I have a trip, so I need to quickly drop my baggage off at the hotel and leave. Yes? So it means to leave your stuff somewhere, to drop it off. The second meaning, guys, is to drive somebody to some place. I'm going to drop you off at the airport. So I'm a taxi driver, you're in my car, and you are going with me to the airport. So I'm just going to drive you there and leave you at the airport. So to drop somebody off somewhere means to drive them to some place. To pick someone up means to take somebody, to let someone get into your car and then drive them somewhere, yeah? I'm going to pick you up tomorrow at 8 at the airport. So somebody is arriving at 8 at the airport and I'm going to wait him or her in my car so they can just get in and we're going to drive, yeah? I'm going to pick them up, take them in my car and drive them somewhere. To look forward, everybody. This one means to wait very, very much for something, not patiently. So you want something very much. For example, you have a trip next year and you are looking forward to it. So you want this trip very, very badly. You want it right now, you can't wait. To look forward is when you can't wait. You want it very much and it's just horrible for you to wait for that to happen. Well, it doesn't have to be a trip, it can be anything. I want to buy a new car. I look forward to buy a new car. I look forward to see you. I look forward to sit on that plane and just fly somewhere else. So it can be anything, but remember, to look forward is to wait something very much and to want it so, so badly. Time for the next phrasal verb, everybody, and this one is to stop over. So to stop over is to have a little stop for a short period of time somewhere, to pick somebody up or to see some place or to take some bags, whatever, but you're not staying there. You just stopped for a couple of minutes, maybe for an hour, doesn't matter, and then you go. It's a short stop. It's not a long stay. So we're going to stop over at that hotel tomorrow to pick my friends up. So we're not going to leave the car. We're not going to go to the hotel and stay there and sleep there. No, we're just going to stop for a little while, pick up our friends and keep going. So to stop over is to stop somewhere for a short period of time. Now, guys, I just want to ask you to leave any comment under this video or any other of my videos about what you would like to see in my videos. I'm looking for new ideas and I would be really grateful and I would really appreciate if you tell me what you want to see and what you want to learn. It would be amazing. It can be songs, movies, TV shows, grammar, vocabulary, whatever you're struggling with. Just leave a comment down below and I will try to shoot my next video about that as soon as possible. Well, thank you anyways. Now, do not stop learning English on this exact moment. Why would you? Click on one of the two videos that you can see over here right now. I hope I do not cover them or they do not cover my face. So click on one of them, guys, and continue learning this beautiful language with Matt. And I'll see you in the next one, guys. Bye-bye.